Today we are going to try something very different. As Mordor against Isengard, in a one-on-one situation, we will not recruit anything else but orcs exclusively. That means no trolls, no Nazguls, no Witch King, no Mummokirs, and of course, not the Balrog from the spellbook either. That's going to be kinda challenging. I hope it's going to work out. Orcs, they are not the strongest units in the game, and especially when you have no leadership available from the Witch King or from the Drummer Trolls, it's going to be nearly impossible. But of course, that's the challenge, and challenges are meant to be difficult. So at the beginning of the game, we will actually, you know, need some lumber mills to get the wood bonus and also the money we will need to build additional orc pits. Our entire castle is going to be filled with orc pits all alone. But it's gonna be fiesta. The problem is, we have only 400 command points available, and orcs, each of them, will cost us 20 command points. So that means we will not be able to have more than 20 battalions of orcs at the same time on the field. And yeah, against Isengard, Isengard is also like a great counter, you know, to Mordor, because our leadership bonuses from the Eye of Sauron, from the Darkness later on, from the spellbook is going to be shut down once Isengard has the Freezing Rain unlocked from his own spellbook. So again, we will need at least 4 lumber mills to get the wood bonus, which is going to make our buildings and structures cost 30% less. That means a orc pits normally, which normally costs 400, will cost us less than 300. Watch this now, 280. So let's build 2 of them already, so we can start spamming lots of orcs all the time. I don't mind about losing them to the Vorklea, that is the Uruk-hai. Let's lead to this spot in the middle of the map. So we will not be able to win this fight, of course. Uruk-hai, this is no rubble of mindless orcs, these are Uruk-hai. So remember, I'm always saying quality goes over quantity. But hopefully, I can prove myself wrong by having a statement and a proof that quantity might also be enough to beat the quality. So shift left click to recruit as many orcs as we potentially can. The only problem we will have is, of course, the lack of command points. Because in BFME 1, you are limited to a set amount, which you can't increase by building additional farms like you can, for example, in BFME 2 or in Rise of the Witch King. But that's not possible in Battle for Middle-earth 1, unfortunately. But it's fine, it's fine. We might also need some Orc Archers later on. Again, Orcs all alone doesn't mean that we will only recruit some Orc Warriors, but also Orc Archers will be definitely needed if we want to be able to push our opponent back, you know? So let's try to fight for the map control in the meantime. The reason why I also choose the map Westwold is because we have also outposts at the bottom side and also at the top side, which we might later on capture to build even more orc pits, you know? That's the plan. So now, look at the base. We have orc pits all alone, my friends. That's going to be fiesta, my dude. Oh, I cancelled it. My bad. I wanted to set a rally point, and this way they can automatically gather in the middle or in the front side of the base. And now we can use 4 of them to creep potentially the Vorklea at the bottom side. And also, we can choose the Eye of Sauron from the spellbook of Mordor. Oh, not Troll Cage. I don't need Troll Cage. I need the Orc Pit exclusively. So now we gotta put more pressure on him. Even more Orcs are required, of course. So right now we have 3, 4, 8 Orc Pits in our base, dude. Again, we will be command points capped all the time. I'm losing my clicks, though. Oh, here's some crossbowmen here trying to punish us, but it's fine. You guys can try to destroy this in the meantime. We can also use the Eye of Sauron to make them stronger a little bit. This way they can creep this a little bit easier and faster. And also level advantage means a lot, even on orcs. The second they have more levels than level 1 or level 2, they will become stronger and stronger and stronger. We will of course lose this fight, because quality goes over quantity, at least in most cases. And soonish we will also have to recruit some orc archers, especially because we need banner and also fire arrow. But beside having those, oh, look, we lost almost the full battalion here. So creeping a Vorklea requires more than 4 orc battalions, actually. Holy guacamole. So we might need even some more there. Just keep up the pressure all the time on our opponent. 24-7. Can we creep this? If yes, they're gonna hit level almost 4. Or they will be level 4, actually. Yeah, there we go. Finally. That's great. Now what we can do is save this level 4 battalion to not lose him. Let's use the Tainted Land. That's gonna grant our orcs 40% increased armor. Keep up the pressure all the time, boys. All the time. send orcs everywhere, literally everywhere, and use the number advantage we have over our opponent, at least for now. And it sounds crazy, but we need to win this game ASAP, just to be make sure that our opponent is not gonna get any stronger units on the field later on. So let's use all these orcs we have, and actually let's send them to his base. We don't need industry because we have nothing to boost. We have no furnaces, no slaughterhouses as we are talking. But what we might need actually is definitely a scavenger from the spellbook, which is going to give us money every time we will kill enemy units, which is gonna happen pretty much all the time. So now let's cancel this and let's recruit at least one orc archer battalion. They even cost more command points. Orcs cost 20, they cost 30. They also cost us 300 resources, which is quite a lot actually, you know. So let's try to creep now the work layer at the top side to build even more orc pets. After this is done, we will be capturing also our seed. Outpost. Scavengers unlocked, that's great. Now, let's capture this outpost. Put pressure on him all the time. Can we maybe kill this orc pit, uruk pit rather? Would be amazing if we could. But it's of course easier said than done. Put pressure on him also, try to cut down his resource income by destroying his lumber mills left and right. Doesn't really matter for the evil faction though, because evil faction will get always enough money. Okay, so you guys going to try now to creep the workline at the bottom right side. We will need some orc archers ASAP on the field. We will combine them with the level 4 orc battalion we have. And also, if you don't know, recruiting orc archers is going to get our orc pits to level 2 faster, which means 25% faster build speed. Also, we will get the chance to buy Fire Arrow and Banner Carry upgrade. And again, we are struggling a lot, of course, to, you know, fight against the Uruks, and he has now even Lords on the field. Who might, you know, look at this level. He's almost level 4 already. He might be level 5 very, very soon. It means additional damage leadership for the Uruks. And again, that would mean that we will have even harder time. But we are creeping this one, slowly but surely. Let's recruit even more orcs from these orc pits. But luckily now, we have a level 4 combat battalion, which is actually pretty nice. We will also need Fire Arrow on them to make them deal a bit more damage, especially structural damage. Because, as you could see, even when you send like a bunch of orcs to his base, it's still quite tough to destroy his structures, you know. So he's creeping this. Let's build another outpost, and you see we are getting crushed here in no time. Guys, please creep this already. Come on now, just focus down the lair before anything else. Let's put up the pressure in the middle. We will lose the fights, but it's okay. As mortal, you are getting power points as you are losing stuff as well, if you don't know that. So, which can be pretty nice, even though the premise of this is that we are not supposed to, you know, summon the Balrog either. So Balrog is not allowed. Just keep fighting here. Eventually we will be out spamming him. Our orc archers are doing a phenomenal job, and now we gotta go for another attack. But we need the orc pit to be level 2 ASAP. So now you my friends, can I please select you all? There we go. Go guys, go. Kill this last Uruk. We were able to creep this, that's dope. Now we can even buy this outpost at the top left side. We are losing the fights in the middle, but that's fine. That's not the end of the world. Now we gotta make a move. We have almost the darkness from the spellbook too. Let's use the Eye of Sauron and even Tainted Land here offensively a little bit. We are only one power open away from getting our darkness, which means even more leadership for the units, which is dope. And keep up the pressure. Destroy his mills at the very same time. Our orc archers are almost level 5. We have now enough power points for the darkness. Let's go for a massive amount of leadership. That's the most leadership we can unlock without the Drummer Troll and without the Witch King from our heroes. So that's as strong as we can become right now. Hopefully it's gonna be enough to eventually deal some damage to his main base. Even though orcs are still dying quite quickly, and our damage output from the archers, because they have no fire, is also pretty bad. Alright, you guys go here to the middle. We need even more orcs, but first of all, let's move on to the top right side. If we can destroy the Uruk pit, that would be actually quite massive. They would buy us so much time. Let's try to do that. Look, Lurtz. We will need ages to kill him. Now the next power point is going to be called the Horde, which is going to increase our production speed of the orcs. That means we will get orcs on the field in no time. But Uruk Pit level 3, very, very tanky building. So we gotta peel back a little bit. We can't finish this off right now. Let's send some more orcs to pick up the level 5 combo. Let's turn. So he's not able to attack the archers, but he's able to attack only... Oh, wait, what's going on? Please fight this, orcs. And that's why I don't like the HD edition, you know, because HD edition is so buggy in compared to the normal edition. We were able to destroy this, okay. We have one orc archer here in the middle of the map. Looks like Lurtz is running for his life, as he should. Even more orc pits are required. Our level 5 combo is doing a phenomenal job, actually. Almost crushing everything here. But make sure that he's not face tanking everything. Just destroy every single lumber mill in the meantime. Make sure that he has no money income, which is very important. And we are getting more and more units at the very same time. We need even more than that, though. We need more than that. We can't even buy anymore. Looks like he has the... See it. Looks like he has the... Feel the fires. As you can see, those lumber mills are glowing now. We killed the Uruk Pit. That's massive. Let's not lose a level 7 combo battalion, shall we? Just destroy. He has no more Uruk Pits on the field right now. He has only Lurtz and he has barely any other unit on the field. Which is dope for us. That's pretty nice. And he has also not a single lumber mill left on the field anymore either. So, long story short, we are in a good spot. But it's not over until it's over. He has one lumber mill, but it's going to be destroyed now. And now we have also the Colder Horde ability. Again, there is no point of using it right now because we won't be able to get any value from it since we are command points capped. But it's fine. Our money is actually pretty good. We have now the chance, if we wanted to of course recruit the Witch King as well, but let's not do that. Now let's group all our units and wait for the darkness, wait also for the units to recover a little bit and try to go for a massive push. Unfortunately, our Orc Pit is not level 2 just yet. More orcs are required. More orcs are required. Let's group all of them together. Put the pressure on him. We need even more orcs, though. We need even more orcs. But again, we can't even buy them because they cost 20 command... Imagine, boys. Imagine if they would also not cost any command points. You know what I'm saying? It would be kind of crazy, am I right? Imagine that for a single second. Orcs? Hey, what are you doing there? imagine orcs, free command points... And also free money. Like, you could have like 5,000 orcs on the field at the very same time. You know, that would be like a crazy situation. But I believe that would be also kind of too busted. Okay, so let's select them all together. And put pressure on them. Because now we have darkness, we have Eye of Sauron, we have Tainted Lands, everything is available. Let's see how much damage we will be able to deal with this many orcs at the very same time. We will find out. Let's use darkness right away. I believe that's gonna be almost impossible for him to defend, but we shall see. We shall see. Without Fire Arrow, it's kind of still tricky. So we need Fire Arrow, definitely. We also need more orcs, though. But we will lose now a couple lots of our orcs, so we can recruit eventually more of them. Orcs for days. The age of Uruks is over. The age of the orcs has come. More orcs are required. Also from these orc pits. We are getting also some more orc archers, if I'm not mistaken. We need like a couple of more. I believe like 2 or 3 more for the orc pit to level 2. Because in order to get your orc pit level 2 from orcs all alone, you will need to recruit lots of orcs, you know? Look at the pressure we are doing, guys. Like, what is this? That's crazy, am I right? I mean, his defense is kind of good because he has level 3 structures now, and level 3 structures from the evil factions like Isengard and Mordor are acting like a tower. So long story short, it's going to be hard for us to finish him off with like 1 or 2 attacks. We might need more than that. That's why killing the Uruk Pit was very important and very necessary. He has still Lurtz on the field, but he's quite low. And what can Lurtz do against such a reckless hate alone? Let's use Eye of Sauron. He has no Freezing Rain yet, and you see... Like, level 3 Orc with Eye of Sauron plus Darkness is still hitting like a truck. Look, in the meantime, we are getting even more Orcs on the field, you know? Kill Lurtz. Kill Lurtz. Combos. kill Lourdes. Nice, we kill Lourdes. Level 8 Combat Battalion. Let's not lose him. Let's not lose him. Would be a shame. We need like two more, man. It's so difficult to actually get our Orc Pit to level 2. Not a single one of these, by the way, is level 2 yet. Which is like meh. Like the amount of experience you gain from getting one Orc Warrior on the field is kind of pretty bad, to be honest with you. Let's press Q. Q will full select every unit, every fighting unit on the field. That of course doesn't count on the Lumbermill workers because they are no fighters, they are actually collectors. Even though they are also able to attack, if you don't know, Lumbermill workers from the Isengard or Mordor faction are also able to deal great amount of damage to the Ents from Rohan. He's trying to rebuild, he has nothing left on the field anymore. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe that. Guys. To be honest, I was expecting it to be a bit harder, but it's a 1v1 situation at the end of the day. And Orcs all alone from Mordor against Isengard, which are the weakest units in the entire game, right? Orcs are very weak, especially when you have no leadership. I mean, we were using Darkness and Eye of Sauron, but we were not getting anything else. No Nazgûl, no Witch King, no Balrog. Was not even needed, to be honest with you. And we are running him down. And if you guys enjoyed this, please let me know in the comment section down below. If you make like 250 likes on this video, we're gonna try to do the same thing, but against two hard armies. I believe 1v7 is not gonna be possible because we will have only 160 command points available, and that means we will, like, with 8 battalions of orcs, we will be command points capped. But maybe we can make it happen in a 1v2 situation. But again, we will only be able to fight against either Isengard or Mordor because we cannot destroy walls with orcs, right? So as we are not able to recruit any trolls or any other siege weapons in the game, so only the evil factions are going to be a possible option for us. Let's use Tainted Land. Let's use Cold Horde. But again, we are not getting any value from it. Now we are getting value. You see how much? Look, you see? Oh my goodness. Yeah, Orcs for this. Heart Army, ladies and gentlemen, has been defeated in less than 18 minutes. Look how many units we lost. We lost almost 1,000 units in the game. We killed way less than we lost. We also, yeah, I mean, like, feats to win. You know, quantity over quality, especially, you know, guys, when you want to try that out yourself, I would recommend you to finish off the game as soon as possible, because if you give your opponent too much time, and he will get stronger and stronger and stronger, with, like, Ballistas and Saruman, eventually Lourdes level 5, and then he's gonna have, like, 2 Uruk pits to get some Uruks, with, like, a quarter of your units, he will be able to win the fight, because, again, Orcs are not meant to be a 1v1 fighter. And also, once the furnaces and slaughterhouses, every single one of them is gonna hit level 3, the base from Isengard or Mordor will have such a strong durability that with orcs all alone, it's gonna be almost impossible to deal the damage you are looking for. So my recommendation is, if you are trying that yourself, as Mordor, orcs only against any hard army, make sure to win the game as soon as possible. GG well played, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck, and as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.